You know, a lot of people have asked me what I think of the firmware update for the G9. Let me think about it. What up, YouTube? I am Sean Nerona, and welcome back to Stuck in Love Films, where we are creative 100% of the time. Today, we are going to be talking about a camera that I have had for about 2 years now, and specifically the 2.0 firmware update that came out late last year. Now, I didn't want to make a video right after I got it. I wanted to actually use the camera with the firmware update after getting vlog and everything into it and kind of giving you my thoughts on how it performed in the real world. Now, I know that the real world has changed a lot since last year, so yeah, let's just enjoy what we got. So the first thing I'll kind of want to touch on is what exactly came in the firmware 2.0 update, and how does it relate specifically to my needs as a video shooter? One of the selling points of this new firmware was that the autofocus would be improved. However, I cannot talk about this because I do not shoot with autofocus. So let's skip that for now. So two very exciting things for me were the picture profiles that are now supported by this camera. So HDL, which is hyperlog gamma, basically HDR video, is now a picture profile in the menu system. And it now supports VLOG L, which you have to buy separately. I'm still mad at Panasonic for doing this to most of their lower end cameras. I feel like they should kind of be more like Sony and just put it in there. You know, you're buying the camera, it might as well just come with it if it can do it, you know? Since the firmware update, I've mostly shot vlog on this camera. I've taken it to a few weddings, used it as a B camera, used it as an A camera in certain scenarios, and it performed great. I was expecting it to perform kind of like a little bit lower than the GH5, but honestly, this thing performed just as good, if not better. And I was very happy finally having that vlog footage that I could actually cut together with my other cameras. It just made post-production a lot easier. It made it easier to match the different shots from each camera. So good. Another thing that was added was the 4K 10-bit internal recording. Now, this camera can now do this up to 30 frames per second. It can now put out a 4K 10-bit 60 frames per second video out of the HDMI into an external recorder. So basically, this thing is like a GH5, right? That's what we're basically getting from this firmware update. Kind of. It still has a record limit of 30 minutes for just a regular like 24 frames per second shooting and 30 frames per second. If you go up to 60 frames, the record limit is 10 minutes. You are getting very high quality video out of this, but it does have its limitations. It is not a GH5 yet. Overall, video looks outstanding. I think it performed fantastic. It's made this camera so much more fun to use, having these new features, you know? Variable frame rate. Anytime you use like anything over 60 frames per second, if you want that like super slow-mo, you're gonna have to go to variable frame rate option. And that records, you know, the super slow motion internally and slows it down for you, so you get to play it back and everything's super slow. When you do this, it lets you use manual exposure. So now let's get to the big question. Is this camera with the firmware update worth it? So if you already have the G9 and you're wondering about the firmware update, do it. It's 100% worth it. I got a lot out of this camera after upgrading the firmware and adding the vlog, and shooting with it has just been an absolute dream. So if you haven't bought a camera yet and you're still thinking about it, you're looking at Panasonic's, you've heard what people say about the GH5, you've heard what people say about the G9, and you're wondering, you know, is there a better option. I would say if you're very video centric, it's still more worth your money to go get the GH5. Now, this camera can do everything the GH5 can do at this point, except it has a record limit. So if you're gonna be shooting longer clips, you're probably gonna want that. The other variable that goes into this is not just the capabilities, but also the price. So Panasonic just came out with their full frame mirrorless line, and they came out with this camera, and the GH5 is kind of an older camera at this point. So the price of it online has declined. You could get it from B&H somewhere between $1,200 to $1,300 at this point. And this camera, because it was newer, you can get it for between $900 to $1,100. If it's brand new, it's still probably going to be around $1,100. But if you can get a GH5 for $1,200, then you're literally only saving $100, which honestly, having no record limit, it's worth that like extra $100 if you're investing money. So technically, there's no real reason to choose this camera over the GH5 if you're doing video, and you're not really saving money. So I feel like this camera is in kind of a weird place right now, because why would you choose to buy this one? Now, this camera does have really good photography features. It does have that screen on top where you can see the settings while you're taking pictures, and that's really helpful for photographers. But if you are a video person, get the GH5. I personally have no regrets. I have loved shooting on this camera. It is my little buddy that I take with me just about everywhere. And I'm gonna keep shooting with it because it's awesome. Just wanted to give you guys my honest opinion. If you like this video, please hit that like button. Subscribe to this channel if you are not already. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a comment, please do so in the comments section below. I will do my best to answer as best I can. And as always, it's not about the gear. It's about you and what you can do with it. Your creativity is the best tool that you got. So I will see you guys in the next one.